for my surroundings, you know, I heard like, I don't need it, you know, it's just hair, man, it doesn't matter, blah blah blah. You have a girlfriend, you know, you don't need to do a hair transplant. My girlfriend said the same thing.
Yeah,
like, I don't need it, it's fine, I don't care if you're bald, you know, like those kind of things.
Maybe you can see a little better, but yeah, it's really well done.
Hey, this is Matt. Welcome back to the channel, guys, where I decided to interview one of my one-on-one clients, Josh, who will share with you how he was able to get his hair back and get an awesome result, which we'll be sharing with you later in this video, as well as all the details around it. But before that, he will share with you as well what were the things he was struggling with before choosing the right doctor and pulling the trigger and making that decision. He will share with you all the fears and doubts he has, probably as many of you guys, before deciding to, you know, whether to get the hair transplant or not. So make sure you stay tuned until the end of this video. It's going to be an exciting video. And before we start, make sure you smash that like button and support this channel if you are enjoying these regular updates from me. And before we start, this video has been brought to you by GoFiber, which are hair building fibers you can use to mask any thinning or patchy areas on your scalp to make your hair look thicker and better. So make sure you check out the link in the video description below where you can visit GoFiber, get a free sample of your choice and try them out. See if you like them. Welcome, Josh. Welcome to the channel. Glad to have you here after, I think it was like over a year since we got in touch. We had a one-on-one video call together and we were discussing the doctor selection and all that. And eventually you got a hair transplant in August 2020. So now it's been almost a year after your hair transplant. So great to see a smile on your face. So how was your situation before your surgery? Now, I mean, not in terms of your Norwood scale necessarily, because we know, we can share the photos also here so the guys can see. But I mean, in terms of confidence, in terms of like socializing also with women, you said you had a girlfriend. So how was it before versus right now?
In terms of girls, not too much different. I think I wasn't too far gone to really like have a detrimental effect. I just wanted to catch it before it happened. But definitely in terms of my mental state, like, I remember always checking my hair in the mirror, you know, knowing my hairline would recede, you know, knowing I would not be happy, constantly thinking about it. I think it really took it away. And also knowing that it's possible, you know, it's possible to actually get a good result if you go to the right place and get a decent hair transplant. It can be fixed, you know, you don't have to always worry, you know. I guess you still have to take some, you know, you still have to take action and take be on medication, all these things. Obviously, that's smart to do. But knowing that there is something like a hair transplant and seeing the result, it really calms you down a lot. And of course, many people would maybe say, ah, man, you just need to get the calmness within, you know, you don't need to have external things put on you. But how can I say it? Many guys, I think the majority would be, even if they reach a very calm state, they would be very anxious to lose their hair, you know, because it's something that you don't have control over. You keep losing it. It's a really terrible process, actually. I like my hair to be nice. I don't care if other people don't like it. I like it like this, right? So it's totally for myself, really. I have a girlfriend, I have a wife now. I still do it, you know. Still get a second or third hair transplant, you know, even if I'm 40.
Because it gives you the confidence and self-assuredness in yourself, and then you can transfer that into other areas and you are more successful in these areas. So this is the most important thing at the end of the day, right? Because you can also lose people who are maybe now telling you some things that you want to hear just to make you feel good. You can lose them, and if you don't have them, then you won't get that security from them, and you will need to have something that you are able to create for yourself. And if a hair transplant will help you create that thing, then definitely go for it. Do you regret the procedure? Like,
oh, no, not at all, man. Like, no, not at all. And hair is also, has a detrimental effect on your looks. Like, I think more than most things, you know, like, obviously you can go to the gym, you can change your clothes, but it really frames your face. You know, if you have a big forehead like me, you know, like if I go bald, like it would be worse and worse, mm-hmm. You know, these small changes with your hair result in huge differences, you know, in my view.
So what were like your fears and doubts and concerns before getting your hair transplant? Like, could you maybe elaborate on that before?
Fears that many people have, you know, you're going to end up with a shitty result. You're going to have like scalp necrosis or something like this. Yeah, the angulation being strange, it being unnatural. You know what I mean? The hairline being lower too much. Like, for example, in my hair transplant, maybe you can see it. I didn't actually go for a full straight line, and he actually didn't recommend me to. he actually decided, like, you know, this is what I really appreciate of him. He said, like, maybe it's better not to lower it too much, because then we can still use some grass for future use.
You could have obviously also, like, kept doing your research for maybe a couple more weeks or months or even years, arrived at the same destination eventually. So why consult it with Matt? Why not just do all that research on yourself?
Well, first of all, I'm busy, right? Like, I have a job, I study at the same time. I could research it, but I just feel, well, first of all, yeah, I wouldn't have the time to go as deep as you do, right? It also, you build up your knowledge over time. It's not like you've been doing this for, I don't know how many years now.
Like almost 5 years.
Almost 5 years. So to reach the same amount of knowledge, I would probably need the same amount of time. And also, you have the experience of having a hair transplant. I don't have that experience. You've spoken to doctors in person. You've spoken to other clients who have had results. So yeah, obviously I could have done it myself, but I don't think I could have had the same knowledgeable evaluation as you do. So that's what I would say.
What helped you to, like, finally do the decision? Because we had the choice already, like, finalized, and then I don't know whether it was the consultation with the doctor or in-person visit with the doctor, which really made you comfortable enough to be like, okay, I'm going in.
Well, I was quite comfortable after you mentioned him already. So I was like, okay, probably this is good enough, because I'd watched many of your videos. So I knew the criteria that you listed, right? And I think you gave me a list of things that I had to ask as well. I actually brought in, I did my own research a little bit. I looked at your questions and I thought, okay, I'm just going to go in with this doctor. And I actually talked to both clinics, or I talked to three clinics even. So actually I was going to go to another clinic until you said, maybe you want to look into that one. And then I actually went to that one at the last second. So I'm very happy I did that, actually. It's quite difficult, actually, to get your mind off a clinic once you feel one is good enough. You know, like, you see one, you're like, I think this is the one. And then you have some sort of confirmation bias. You want to kind of stick with this one. So this is actually why I also thought, like, okay, maybe it's good to contact someone more knowledgeable. I mean, I've been watching your channel. I thought, okay, this guy is honest. He knows a lot more. So I think, you know, maybe I just check what he thinks. Probably he's going to approve of this clinic. And they just said, like, you know, this is okay, but this doctor might be better. Dr. Abersohn, right? He eventually said, he sat down with me. He took he first answered me an email. Then he said, maybe you want to just come in, then we can talk about it. And he even gave me more information than I wanted to know. Instead of just answering my questions, he also gave me some more information and gave me some more caveats. And so that gave me, like, okay, this guy knows more. He's more involved as well, because the others were just, the surgeon was not too involved. Like, they just gave the medical checklist, I think. And other than that, the nurses were mostly doing the extraction and incision. It's actually interesting. Like, when I went in and when they drew the hairline right before the start, I was like, could you maybe do this part? Like, because this part has not been done. It's only the sides, right? It's not this. So, and I was saying, maybe you should also, like, put a little bit here. You know, that's what I said. This just like a few. And he's like, no, we're not going to do that. You know, he said, let's just leave it. It's going to be fine. And you maybe need it in the future, blah, blah. And he just put a few in, like, he just kind of dripped. I can see it, like, a few grafts are here, but not here. So it's like, he even adjusted it a little bit. It's, yeah, quite delicate work, I would say, you know. And this is the thing too, like, eventually he said, you know, if it ends up being maybe a few hundred grams more, I'll just do it without charging you extra, you know, if I think the result looks better. He said, no, we're just going to agree on, like, around 1200 grafts. We're going to do this area. Let's say if I need 1300 or 1400 to make it more natural, I will do it without, you know, charging you.
And I really have to say that for 1200 grafts, this is a really good density and coverage type of trade-off that you got from this surgery. Yeah. And it's a sign of very high survival rate, obviously, which is usually, like, almost the highest when you get, like, with a smaller FUE, like 1000 grafts or 1500. The chance of the survival is obviously the best compared to, like, a mega session of 4000 grafts or so. So this is this played in your favor for sure, and we see that it's really, like grew back, like, wonderfully, and I'm really, really happy about that as well.
Father of my friend, he's a doctor. And we had a huge debate on the dinner table, you know, and he was like, you shouldn't do it. You know, you can get infected. You can get this, that. And I had a patient with a hair transplant. He looked really bad. So he really recommended against it. And even he says, like, that looks really good. You know, you did a good job. You know, like, even he says, like, it looks pretty nice. You know, and even some guys like, wow, you really can see it. Some guys are really against it at first. Yeah, it's funny. Because also, for my surroundings, you know, I heard, like, I don't need it, you know, it's just hair, man, it doesn't matter. blah, blah, blah. Ah, you have a girlfriend, you know, you don't need to do a hair transplant. My girlfriend said the same thing.
Yeah.
Like, I don't need it. It's fine. I don't care if you're bald, you know, like those kind of things.
What does she think right now after you have done it, despite her telling you don't do it?
Yeah, I think she still kind of has the same attitude a little bit. But she does say like, oh, yeah, I cannot tell. It's very like, I cannot even see it's a hair transplant, you know. This is also really funny. She's like, yeah, to be honest, you know, I thought you actually were balding a little bit, but I didn't tell you because, you know, I didn't want to hurt your feelings, you know.
You decided to get your hair back in like August 2020. When was the time when you realized, which month after the procedure was the month when you said like, man, this is going to be good. This is going to look good.
I would say month 5, 6, and then maybe 6, 7, those months. It was like, okay, if it stays like this, it's already okay. But I actually see maybe month 6, 7 was already 95-90% or so.
So what would you recommend or what would you suggest to somebody who is still, you know, has been maybe researching for already some time and still unsure, should he do it or not, you know, doubting the decision potentially?
I would ask them like, what are your doubts? What are you scared of, first of all, right? I mean, this is a really safe procedure. I mean, if you look at all the cosmetic procedures, this is probably, if not maybe one of the safest ones you can do, as long as you have a good doctor, of course. So I would say don't hesitate too much. It's not that big of a deal. Don't listen to your surroundings if you're really sure about it. Yeah, make sure you get in contact with someone who knows a lot about it also. Like, yeah, you could still, even if you think you know a lot, you still have some, you know, blind spots that you could maybe potentially fill in for them, you know. Yeah, it eases your mind.
How was the overall experience with me, right, during the one-on-one call and also the support, the emails? How was the support? Was the advice what you expected or did you expect something else?
I actually just expected it worse than it was. Like, I was actually I appreciated the first process. I thought like, okay, after you're done with me, you will move on. That's what I consider. But he actually emailed me after 6 months, even after 12 months. I even asked you some extra questions about shampooing, I think, and some topicals and maybe some other medication, and you always replied. So actually, the experience I have had with my hair transplant doctor has been very similar to the experience I've had with you, in a sense, you always kept contact, even though you didn't have to, right? Like, you've done your job, I've done my hair transplant, like, you didn't have to reply to my email, and probably I would have even thought, like, okay, that's normal if he doesn't reply because, you know, you've been already giving me your time. So that's been really nice. And also, I think maybe I didn't look enough at the website in the beginning. I just thought, okay, I'm just going to get your view. But you actually looked at other clinics for me, right? Which I didn't expect. I just thought you were going to evaluate what I already presented and say, this is not good enough. Maybe you should look for others, then look for it and then bring it back to me, something like this. But you took over that work a bit. Because if you don't know what to look for and maybe you know a little bit, it's really stressful among other things, right?
Yeah, it saves a lot of work. I mean, I have to be honest with you, Josh. It's like some guys come to me and they've been also like in it for longer than me. There are some guys who have had like 3-4 hair transplants that just contact me for a reassurance and they already know a lot, you know, but sure, they just need that reassurance. So it's not always like Matt will tell you the top secret that you don't know. I mean, it happens like in 50% of the time, but really sometimes guys really are just, they're already well equipped and they just need these little tweaks and some reassurance.
Same in my case. I would say right now, My knowledge is much more than it was before. Like, I would say I know most things to look out for, but I would probably still go to you if I go for a second.
All right, guys, that was it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. And for all of you guys who are considering a hair transplant, you want to do it the safe way. You want to get a great result like Josh here. And you want to also avoid unnecessary mistakes that many guys are still doing right now, things that can cost them over-harvested or poorly managed donor area, unnaturally looking hairlines or pluggy temples, things like these, make sure you start with a free education on my website here below where you can get my free ebook, 5 Things I Wished I Had Known Before My Hair Transplant, or watch my free video, which is called The Most Important Video You Need to Watch Before Your Hair Transplant. It will help you get a better perspective over like what you are signing up for if hair transplant is something you are seriously interested in. If you are somebody who's already about to get a hair transplant in the next month or two, you definitely don't want to make this decision in a rush. And in such case, it's very helpful for you if you sign up for a one-on-one call with me, where I can give you all that perspective during a 60-minute video call with me and explain you all things necessary towards getting the best result, finding the right doctor, avoiding all the pitfalls, evaluating the doctor that you have already selected, and giving you my view onto your overall situation. That was it from me for this video. See you in the next one. Take care, guys.